Well, a global public good is something we all benefit from, but we don't all necessarily contribute to creating. So something really concrete is the climate all around us, and it can be affected by the actions of others, but we all feel those impacts. And it can also be something really abstract, like financial stability, which we'll talk about in a moment, but even that, the actions of other people can affect us all, and it was only a little more than 10 years ago that we were all affected by mistakes that happened in other countries. Well, global public goods are absolutely necessary for everyone around the world to participate in growth in the world, to have truly inclusive development. On the downside, we see the impacts of climate change on some of the poorest parts of the world the most severely. Anytime there's problems in the financial system, again, those least well off are affected the most. More positively, if we make progress towards a sustainable environment, if we build a financial system that serves everyone, then we all benefit. And in each case, we have to all invest, particularly the advanced economies like France, like the UK, in building those global public goods. Well, financial stability has had its ups and downs over the past 75 years. We're here to celebrate and reflect on the 75 years of the Bretton Woods institutions. And they were put in place and they ushered in a very long period of relative financial stability. So the financial system worked for people across the world, and the trading system worked for people across the world. And then about 35 years ago, a little more, that system started to break down, and it ushered in a period of financial instability, very high unemployment, very high inflation, and lots of suffering, again, not just in the countries that started the problem, but everywhere around the world. And it took a number of decades to get things back on track. About 20, 25 years ago, things again were on track, and we were able to widen the participation in the global economy to the former Eastern Bloc countries in Eastern Europe, and very importantly to China and other countries in Asia. Another long period of financial stability and prosperity, but we took our eye off the ball, and what happened was a very sharp period of financial stability 12 years ago. We have made a commitment for that never to happen again, and that's why meetings such as these are so important, because the focus is what can we do to invest in that global public good, financial stability, a system that works for all. What can we do to make sure that it's there for the next 75 years? And this is where a meeting like this is showing leadership.